Let me ask you a simple question, okay? I'll give you three instances. Mentally, just think of the answer, okay? Let's say you're a student. You're a student and you're studying in the exam and you manage to get, let's say, out of 60 students, you get the sixth highest mark, okay? What do you think your parents would normally tell you? Oh, you got sixth. I'm sure you're going to improve and get fifth. So next year you work hard, you get fifth. What do you think they would tell you next? If you work hard, you can get fourth. Okay, same thing with the scoring marks. Especially Indian parents. If you score, let's say, 69%, oh, if you do one more, you'd be in the 70% bracket. Then when you go to 70, oh, if you study hard, you can go up to 75. Then when you go 75, they push you to 80. Okay. There's a progression. Let me give you the second example. Let's say you're going to the gym. And you're lifting weights for your chest. You start off with 10 kilos. From 10 kilos, you start pushing to 15 kilos. Wow, there's progress. From 15 kilos, you become strong after some time. They become 20 kilos. 20 kilos. So what do you keep doing? You'll push 20, 25, 30. And every time you push, every time you increase, every time there's a breakthrough, you'll share it on Facebook, you'll share it on social media, Instagram, Twitter, and you'll always put a motivational quote, never give up on your dreams, push yourself harder, you can do it. And yes, you'll also share, I started off at X and today I'm at Y, same thing which I've done. I started off with 100 meters, which I could just run. Slowly became 200 meters, slowly 400, 800, 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer. Over a period of time, and today I can do 7. So, and obviously in my head there's, okay, 8, 9, 10 and 1. Okay. One last example, okay? Until now, I hope you're with me. Last example. When you started your career, you are earning maybe let's say $1,000 a month. Very soon, you know, you say, okay, I'm earning 1,000, I want to earn more. You work hard, you get a bonus, you get here and there. Then your goal next year is $1,200 per month. Then becomes 1,500. Then becomes, you know, 2,000. Then 3,000. Then 4,000. By the way, don't mind this. This is a painter. It's painting the house. So it becomes 4,000. So it keeps increasing. Your drive and your desire to earn more money, to earn a bigger salary, to earn a bigger position, to earn a bigger income, keeps increasing. And you know this is a reality, right? We all target to earn more. If you look at human beings in general, we all do the same. We want a bigger house, we want a bigger car, we want a better life. You want not just one car, you want multiple cars. You don't want to go economy class, you want to go maybe business class, you want to go first class. So we as human beings, we always strive to push ourselves more, you know. I have one business, okay, one branch, I'll open two branches. Okay, I'll open three branches. I'll open in four cities. Then I'll open in two countries, three countries. So we like to expand, we like to grow. So now, what am I coming at? What am I trying to tell you here? Right, doggy? Yes, doggy. How are you? They get scared, you know. If you go to them, they get scared. So what I was telling you was, Today, when I was running, I actually realized something. It's a very strange realization. Today, when I was running, you must have seen, I showed you this painting. I slept at around, I think, 5, 5.30. Because I was painting the house. There's so much of fucking work, man. So much of fucking work in the house. You know, just speaking off topic, if you ever were to clean your house and sort your house properly and completely, I can challenge you that you'll be shocked and surprised. If you check each and everything, you'll be shocked and surprised how much of shit is there, how much of excess stuff is there, how much of unwanted stuff is there, how much stuff you're storing, how much stuff you do not need, how much stuff... it's unbelievable. I mean, I just try to complete one task and then something else comes up. I complete one thing and another thing comes up. Trust me, just... if you ever think of sorting your house or cleaning it up or removing things which are unwanted, get ready for almost a month of slogging your ass. Fuck. It's like, when I do one thing, there's another thing. When I clean one thing, there's another thing. Oh, anyway, I'll make a video on that later. Okay, so I was cleaning the house and I slept at... painting the house. I slept at 5.30. You can see all paint. My fingers, it's gone. Okay. So after I slept, I thought I would get up at around 2 o'clock or something. I got up at 8.40 or 9 o'clock. I tried to sleep again, couldn't sleep. So got up, had my coffee, everything else, sorted a few things here and there, and then I decided to go for my run. Now today was a long distance run, it was 7 kilometers. And 7 kilometers is for me running to the top of the hill which is there, and you might have seen my previous video, it's an uphill, slow uphill. It's a kind of a painful run, uphill. I have to run 3 rounds, going up, coming down, going up, coming down, going up, coming down, 3 times. And then 1/3 all the way till here and back to the starting position, that's 7 kilometers. So I normally do 7 kilometers in my long run. Now I have been doing this for every single day since I think now 2 years or whatever. And it has been progressively increasing. I started off with 100 meters, went to 200 meters, went to 400, 800, 1 kilometer, then 2 kilometers, then 1.5, then 2, 2.5, then 3. Then I'd always keep increasing the distance. Like suppose I would run every day till here, then the goal would be, okay, run till there. Be consistent with that. Okay, I ran till there, then run till a little extra. So this continued for all these months and years. Now it has been like, I think 3 years since I've been doing this exercise non-stop. So until now, I used to enjoy the process. Okay, I used to love the process. I would get up and I had to do my run. Today, however, when I got up, I was like, okay, I got 3 rounds and 1/3. But as I put on my shoes and started to run, I was actually, even before the run started, it's like, no, as the run started, I was thinking like, shit man, another 2 more rounds left and 1/3. Okay, focus. So suddenly I just snapped out of it and asked myself, am I fucking enjoying this? Why is it suddenly become painful? Why is it suddenly become like boring? Why is it suddenly become like a chore? Like, shit, yeah, I have to complete. From being like, yes, I'm going to do it, or yes, I'm enjoying the process, I was actually, fuck. Okay, put your head down and complete this first round. You got 2 more rounds. And then I started to backtrack and I realized, lately, I've not been enjoying myself. Lately, I've been like, whenever I've been doing exercise, I've been like, not again. Oh, okay. Okay, I need to keep the focus, keep the energy. So I wasn't actually enjoying myself, and you know, then I asked myself, then what the fuck is this? Why am I doing it? if I'm not enjoying myself. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not going to stop exercise. But why am I doing so much if I'm not enjoying myself? You know, have you noticed people tend to push themselves more and more and more until the point they either get sick or they get broken or they get injured? Bodybuilders, powerlifters, athletes, they push themselves more, more, more until they get injured or a permanent injury or they get hospitalized. Business people, they keep doing more, more, more until one day they finally get burnt out. YouTubers, they put video after video after video, and after 6-7 years, they just say, I'm just burnt out. You know, it can happen to anybody, okay? Now for me, 3 years, I've been doing here, there, more, 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 more. Now it has come to the part where it came today. Like, I'm not enjoying this, man. So then I ask myself, okay, I have 3 rounds and 1/3. I'm just finishing the first one. So what should I do? Immediately my mind said, okay, I'll do half. That is 2 rounds. Just 2 rounds and I'll stop. But then I told myself, listen, you're not feeling up to the mark today. Just do 1 round and stop. So I was nearly finishing. I stopped at 1 round. I stopped and I don't know, I just felt good about it. I felt, oh, okay, wow, nice. Felt energy there. I felt, and yes, I have to, I'm thinking about the house. Yeah, you can say that there are various factors. I hardly slept and all that, but the main thing which I'm trying to tell you here is, you know, sometimes I think we need to scale back on our goals. This, you know, we live in a society where bigger, faster, stronger, greater is applauded. But, you know, taking it easy, bringing a few notches down is looked down upon. Like, how many times have you heard this say, push yourself out of your comfort zone. Even I've said it, push yourself out of your comfort zone. You know, dare to dream bigger. I've not said that. But like, for example, UAE has the tallest skyscraper. They'll build an even taller one. Then they'll build an even taller one. Then they'll build two. What happened in the Palm Island? They build one. Even before it go complete, they build 1, 2, 3, 4 plus world plus Palm plus universe plus world islands. I mean, sometimes we don't know where to stop. It's like powerlifters from 100 kilos, they want to bench press 200 kilos. People want to break world records. You know? I'm not saying that is bad. But the point I'm trying to tell you here is, I think sometimes we need to enjoy the journey. You need to enjoy what you're doing. And if you're not enjoying, I think you need to stop. And this can be whether it's a relationship, if you're in a marriage or whatever, and the spark has vanished, you need to figure out a way to bring that back or find a new purpose or meaning. Whether it's marriage, whether it's your job, whether it's your career, whether it is friendships, whether it's relationships, whether it's even exercise. You know, if you're not doing it, either scale down or ask yourself, okay, what would give me the meaning? Now for me, I think I've realized the 7 kilometers is a little bit of a, I don't know, a little bit of a chore. Maybe I'll just do 2 kilometers for the next couple of days. Maybe I'll scale it down. Maybe I'll keep it easier. Maybe I won't go uphill. Maybe I'll try something new. Maybe I'll bring push-ups or squats. Try something new, a little bit of variety. You know, so the reason for this is I need to, obviously I need to do exercise, but I need to find out the passion, the meaning, the purpose, the reason for doing it. Otherwise, why? Why are we doing it? See, even if it's your marriage, even if it's your relationship, and if you are just burnt out or if you have lost the meaning, the passion, why are you in it? Either figure out a way to rekindle it, or I think it's time to move on, man. I know this might sound controversial. You'll be like, oh, if you're married, what? You can't force emotions, you can't force feelings, you can't force someone to love you, right? Same thing with even your job. Is your job become monotonous? Is it become boring? Is it become predictable? Is it become like, shish, you don't want to get up in the morning. From once upon a time being like, yes, you got up in the morning and you were so hyper, and now you're like, oh fuck, not again, I just want to sleep a few more minutes or whatever. That means you have lost the purpose, the passion. I think we live in a day and age where there's so much of peer pressure. Oh, he achieved greatness, he achieved bigger, faster, stronger, larger. From pressure from parents, pressure from friends, pressure from people. Like even my wife, when I achieved, let's say, 100,000 baht I made, achieved a client. Wow, yay, we'll make now 200,000, we'll make 300,000. Like she's dreaming big. Oh, we'll make 1 million. It's normal. We all have this tendency for more, bigger, greater, faster, stronger. Even for our children. Oh, you got 70%. You can get 80. You can get 90. I think sometimes we need to scale things down. Scale things down a notch. And ask ourselves, are we actually happy? Do you still have the joy in doing what you're doing? Are you enjoying the process? Because if you're not enjoying the process, if you're not happy, then what's the point of pushing yourself more, more, more? For me, what I realized is the 7 kilometers, okay, pushing for 8 and then, yay, I did 7, now I'm doing 8 and bragging about it on social media and might feel good. Wow, Law, you're an inspiration. Wow, Law, you're great. But am I happy? Yes, I'll not be admired because we only admire the biggest, greatest, strongest, the alpha male, the one at the top. But I think sometimes you need to look within and ask yourself, am I happy? And then the popular vote will not matter. What people think will not matter. What you feel, what you want, that is what truly matters. For me, for the next few days, I'm going to scale down my goals where running is concerned. Exercise, I'm going to scale it down, bring some variety, try something new, and see how does the experimentation work. And if I feel the same, whatever it is, whether it's marriage, whether it is my work, whether it's earning money, you need to mix and match and find out how can I bring in the passion again. Maybe not push yourself so much, maybe push a little lower, maybe do things a little bit more relaxed, but find the sense of joy and happiness in the journey, you know, not the destination. Because end of the day, I've always told you, you just have one life, man. One. You don't know when it's going to be your last day. So you might as well enjoy the journey, right? The process. So this is what I wanted to share with you guys. I don't know if it makes sense. Let me know, what do you think? Do you think parents pressurize their children? Especially Indian, I think Indian or Asian parents, to achieve more, get bigger marks, more rank. Do we have the pressure in our office, bigger targets? And do we give ourselves a pressure, you know? Bigger house, faster car, better holiday, more salary, more bank balance, bigger business? Or is it something as simple as going to the gym and pushing more weights and showing off? I think that is what people do just to get more likes and positive comments. They don't know where to stop, and that's where plastic surgery and all that shit comes in. So let me know your thoughts. I love reading your comments. Put down your thoughts down below, and this is me signing off. You guys take care. All right?